present Europigeon with John Shuttleworth. One man's bid for Eurostardom.
She looks a bit wrong there, didn't she? Frances Ruffial with... Oh, nice echo. Nice reverb there. That's this year's UK entry for Eurovision. It did work well in a car advert, but is it good enough to secure first place in Dublin on Saturday night in the 39th Song for Europe? I'm not so sure. In fact, I'm a little bit worried about our prospects. You see, it's a long time since we had a winner. 1981 with Bucks Fizz. Remember that one? Yeah. You see, it's catchy. And that's a secret ingredient which today's songwriters seem to have forgotten all about. It's a sad fact, but gone are the days when we could have a guaranteed winner with the likes of Lulu. Or Sandy Shaw. Yeah, or Cliff. Mustn't exclude Cliff. Actually, Cliff only came second, so we shouldn't really include him. Sorry, Cliff. No, he seemed like he won at the time, you know. The point is, we're not producing winners anymore. And it was with this problem in mind that I sat down one morning, a couple of years ago, and wrote perhaps my finest song to date, Pigeons in Flight. Pigeons in flight, I want to see you tonight. Oh, I want to hold you, if I may be so bold to, and tell you some things that you'd like to hear. Oh, my dear, in your ear, pigeons in flight, I want to see you tonight. Yeah. Do you like it? It's catchy, isn't it? And imagine my delight when I discovered that Michael Ball was to be representing the UK that year. A young, powerful vocalist. I like the way he punches the air on key phrases. You know, it's a nice knockabout quality to Michael's work. And yet I knew he had the emotional maturity to handle the sensitive lyric. But it was £100 to enter, plus VAT, for each song, which is a bit pricey in these recessionary times, you know. I haven't got that kind of money. But I wasn't going to be knocked down at the first hurdle, so I rang up the competition organisers with a little proposal. I wonder if it'd be possible to post-date the cheque to after the contest. Because, you see, I'm very sure that we've got a winner with my song, Pigeons in Flight. And we feel confident that, you know, it would win and then it would obviously pay for itself. Would that be possible?
I don't know if we can do that. I'll have to check. Hang on a second.
Thank you.
Hello.
Hello.
I'm very sorry, we can't do that.
You can't?
No.
Well, there's one alternative. If I were just to send the chorus and possibly just send a cheque for, say, £25,
would that be possible? We do need the cheque with
because
the entry. We can't accept a cheque for, you know, less than the amount.
But I feel certain that if Michael were to hear just the chorus, you know, he'd want to sing it. I mean, sorry, can I just sing a little bit of it to you? Because everybody that hears it, you know...
It wouldn't be any use.
Well, you know, I'd appreciate your judgment.
I'm not qualified to give that judgment, then.
Are you not?
No.
Well, how much for an intro?
I will never know, because at that point, mysteriously, the phone went dead. Reluctantly, I resigned myself to being excluded from the Eurovision Song Contest 1992.
What's another year for someone who's lost everything that he owns?
Well, that's right. There was always next year's contest.
What's another year for someone who's getting used to being alone?
No, it wasn't that bad, Johnny, because Christmas was coming up. Oh, yes, had a fantastic time, the whole family together. Mary bought me a shielded 10-metre extension lead, which I've always wanted, so I was very happy. And then I saw a picture of Michael Ball in Bella. You know, I was certain that my song was just right for Michael, and it was very upsetting to think that he'd never even get to hear it. I voiced my frustrations to next-door neighbour and soul agent Ken Worthington, who seemed sympathetic, although he had a little enigmatic smile on his face. And he kept chuckling, but he wouldn't tell me what the joke was.
No.
Eventually, he led me to his lounge.
This way, John.
Where he made a phone call, and within seconds, the cause of his mirth became apparent.
Hello?
Hello. Can you tell me the title, please?
Yes, it was Pigeons in Flight. You see, John?
Oh, Ken.
It's happening.
This is marvellous news.
Yes, well.
You know, it's come at a lovely time.
Happy New Year.
It's when I was really down. After, you know, getting a bad cold.
Yes.
Because you've got a bad one as well, haven't you?
I have. Shocker.
Because we both went out to a dinner dance last night and we got caught in a downpour. But for you to tell me this now, that we're still in a song for you.
Oh, yes, we are. Definitely.
You know, with a fighting chance. It's marvellous news.
Yeah, no problem.
And it's just the tonic that I need.
Well, you know.
Oh, hello. Did you actually enter through us or for Basker?
No, through you. I sent it by carrier pigeon.
Pardon?
With a cheque attached to the cassette.
Carrier pigeon.
And we released it from Euston Station and it should have arrived by 5 o'clock.
Very funny.
On the day.
I don't think we've actually had it, you see.
Very what funny. Floor are you on?
Oh, God.
7th floor.
Yes. Well, that's right.
Give me the phone.
We should have been able to reach it. Would the windows have been open?
The windows?
Yes.
Ken, give me the phone.
Would they not?
Come on.
What do you
it's
mean?
Not funny.
Would the windows be open?
Because we sent it.
Ken.
By carrier
come
pigeon.
Come on, the joke's over. That was a nasty trick to play. A nasty trick.
No, it wasn't.
Sorry,
excuse me.
No, it wasn't.
Excuse me, I'm sorry.
You're being oversensitive.
Hello?
Yeah, this is John Shuttleworth here. Sorry, that was my agent. He's having a New Year's prank.
Oh.
Lovely.
Yeah, I'm sorry
no,
about that.
No, John, if you can't take a joke...
No.
You're in serious trouble, aren't you?
Yeah,
if you
I
can't
do
take a joke.
The thing, the reason I'm...
Sorry, John. Sorry.
I was furious with Ken. Why did he do that? Why? You know, it was a crazy thing to do. But having said that... Something marvellous had happened.
Ooh, yeah.
My interest in the competition had been reawakened.
Hello, is Michael Ball there, by any chance?
Michael Ball? I think you got the wrong theatre. I think you went the Prince of Wales, Aspects of Love.
Oh, is that what he's in now?
Yeah.
I thought
well,
he was in Phantom.
Not here, not in Thunderbirds.
Hello, is Michael Ball there by any chance?
Michael Ball?
Yes.
Good Lord, no, Michael Ball left here 12 months ago.
Did he?
Yes.
Right, I thought he might have done, but
yes.
He was in Aspects of Love.
Well, he was, when he first opened, yes.
Mm.
About 2.5 years ago.
How might I get in contact with him, do you know?
Now, let me see where, who would be likely to know, because I don't even know who his agent is. No, and of course, you see, on his dresser or his private assistant, you know, sort of thing. She doesn't work here anymore, and I don't know where she is.
Oh. All my friends say I'm crazy. Night after night I'm waiting. Say that I'm wrong. Then you tell me that I'm coming on too strong. One step out of time.
Good afternoon, this is a telecom warning. I'm sorry, the offices are now closed.
The warning.
Can't believe that it's true. Now I'm one step out of time. One step.
Sharky?
That's a funny name for a girl.
I know.
Is this the right number for Michael Ball?
Yes.
Right. Is he there, please?
No, he's not. Can I help?
I've got to get a cassette to him.
Right. Would you like to send it to us?
I see. Why is that?
Well, because we're his agent.
Congratulations and jubilations. I want the world to know I'm happy as can be. I want the world to know I'm happy as can be.
I'm Sharky.
Hello, it's John Shuttleworth here.
Hello.
Hello. Have you received the cassette for Michael Ball?
I have, yes. Mm. And we've unfortunately had a listen to it, but it was just too late to put it in.
Oh.
So I've actually sent it back into the post to you.
Oh. No.
Yeah. So
did Michael not hear it then?
Well, no. Well, we actually listened to it here just for curiosity.
Yeah.
But what was the name of the song?
Pigeons in Flight.
Pigeons in Flight.
I want to see you tonight.
But Michael, if Michael
were to hear it personally, I'm sure that he'd be able to overturn the panel's decision.
Yes.
Right, well...
you see, you did promise me.
I'm sorry, Mr. Sharkey, his agent, has actually listened to it, and he's acting for him.
John! John!
Okay?
Let me have a word.
Just 1 second.
Put me on to her. Thank you. Hello.
Won't do any good, Ken.
Yeah, this is Ken Worthington. I'm representing John. I just wondered if there's anything that we can possibly do.
No, I'm sorry. I've already said to him, there's nothing. No, nothing at all. Okay?
Can we not offer you a financial sweetener or anything like that?
I'm sorry, no. Thank you.
No.
Bye-bye.
No. Bye-bye.
It's disgusting.
Bloody hell!
Hey!
Bloody ridiculous!
Ken, don't break the phone, please. There's no need for that sort of behaviour. In a last-ditch attempt to persuade Michael Ball to sing my song, I hurriedly dispatched an audio cassette which offered a compromise. His song, One Step at a Time, with my song, Pigeons in Flight, played over the top. The result, I'm sure you'll agree, is an irresistible musical cocktail. Pigeons in flight, I wanna see you tonight. To hold you again, if I may be so bold to, and tell you some things that you'd like to hear, my dear, in your ear. Pigeons in flight, I wanna see you tonight.
One step at a time.
Pigeons in flight. Incredibly, Michael decided not to do it, and as a result, limped in a poor second. Last year, I didn't bother entering the contest, as I considered the UK representative, Sonia, too bubbly to sing Pigeons in Flight.
What's another year for someone who's lost everything that he owns?
And this year, I missed the deadline, because I was a bit preoccupied with dismantling some steel shelving that I found round the back of the hospital. It was a bit buckled, you know. It's fine now. But, what can you do?
When you think it's all over, they let me down. Dry your tears and forget all your sorrow. Try to smile when you say goodbye.
Well, that's right. You see, I've had an idea. Because we're in Europe now, aren't we? It's free trade with the other members of the community. So why not offer my material to a country that would appreciate a snappy lyric and a haunting melody?
Try to sing a something, Christine.
Hello, could I speak to the Norwegian ambassador, please?
Who's speaking?
It's John Shuttleworth.
John?
John Shuttleworth. I don't think he'll know me, but... it's basically I got a proposition to make about the Eurovision Song Contest. Have you got an entry for this year? Because Norway always seem to come last, I note,
yes,
with nil pois. And you see, I'm a songwriter, and I was wondering if I could offer my services to Norway for this year's contest.
Yeah. Then I think you should speak to somebody in the press office.
Oh, yes.
Yeah,
Can you put me through?
Yes.
Thank you. Hello, yes. My name's John Shuttleworth, and basically I was wondering if you had an entry for this year's Eurovision Song Contest.
No. Norway. We haven't.
You haven't?
No. Hallelujah.
I'd found a country that would take my work seriously. For Norway's track record in the contest is atrocious, to put it mildly. You know, they keep coming last with null poids. And I think this is why they're killing the whales, actually, because they're very angry. They're obviously looking for a scapegoat. But they shouldn't be attacking marine life, should they? That's crazy. No, they should be harpooning the songwriters. Yeah. No, but seriously, why do Norway keep coming last? What's the problem?
Well, the official reason was that they weren't good enough for the entries.
Judge for yourselves with the 1978 entry by Jan Tigan, which was so bad that Terry Wogan felt compelled to issue a warning before we'd even heard it.
Now, Norway have never won the contest. Frankly, without any prejudice, I don't think this one is going to do it for them either.
Strain in his voice. And so it was with confidence and a certain sense of benevolence that I dialed the hotline to NRK, a TV company in Norway's capital city, Oslo. Oh, shut up.
Hello, do you speak English?
Yes.
Oh, yes, I'm ringing about the Eurovision Song Contest.
Yes.
I've been put on to you by the Norwegian Embassy in England.
Mm-hmm.
Basically, I'm a fan of the contest, and it's been very upsetting for me every year to see Norway come last, you know, with
mm-hmm.
with nil point.
Mm-hmm.
And I was wondering if I could offer my services to your country as a songwriter. I got a lovely song called Pigeons in Flight,
mm-hmm.
which I thought would be excellent for a couple, a man and a lady, to sing in traditional Norwegian dress, ideally.
Uh-huh.
Would you like to hear a little bit of it to hear if it'd be suitable?
Me?
Yes. Well, I mean, I know I'm not Norwegian, but I could live in the country for a few weeks to overcome legal problems in that department. Just hear a little bit of it.
Mm-hmm.
1 second, hang on.
Pigeons in flight, I wanna see you tonight. Maybe so bold to and tell you some things that you'll like to hear, oh my dear, in your ear. Pigeons in flight.
And it, what do you think?
Yes, that's melody.
Nice melody?
Yes, nice melody.
Oh, thank you.
Nice melody, she said. What a shame she was only the receptionist and that everybody else had gone home for the weekend.
I'm trying to call back then.
Yes.
On Monday.
I will.
Yeah.
I will indeed.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you very much.
You?
Thank you much. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Very excited. Bye.
Bye.
If you liked it, I think I'm onto something.
Throughout the weekend, I practised Pigeons in Flight in preparation for that all-important rendition on Monday morning for the MD of R. Kayla. However, not everybody was sympathetic to my needs.
Phone, John. Are you going to get it, or have I got it? Eh?
Shut up.
You shut up.
Oh.
Sick of this.
Sick.
Hello? Yes, Ken. It's Ken.
Hello, Ken. What is it?
Hello.
Oh.
Have you got a football team in there?
I'm extremely busy, Ken, so please be as brief as possible.
Gareth. Yes, I will. Gareth. Yes, can you turn the bloody noise down, please? Because I'm trying to have a nap.
Yes.
After my Sunday roast.
Yes, I appreciate that.
Very inconsiderate.
Monday morning came, but I was unable to get to the phone, as I had rather a lot of jobs to do for my wife. And when I finally got through, I met with the same problem that I'd encountered on Friday.
At this hour.
Yes, I've left it a bit late, haven't I?
Anyone there at the moment, but...
Is it dark? Has it gone dark where you are?
It's dark?
Yes.
Yes?
Yes, I forgot that. You see, I've just had my lunch. It's quite...
Oh, I see.
Still daytime in England.
Yes. Well, I'll try Usvod.
Usvod?
Yes.
Right. Can you put me through?
Yes.
Oh, thank you very much. Thank you.
I waited. And I waited.
Hello?
Good morning.
Is he not there?
Hello?
Hello?
Yeah?
Is Usvod there?
Wait.
Usvod.
I thought those were the gone, I should go.
Hello? Hello? What's that? I
thought those were telephone.
Hello, could I speak to Usvod, please?
Well, he is absent for a moment, for 2 days.
Is he out tobogganing?
Pardon?
Is he out tobogganing, do you know? Is he sledging or anything? Winter sports?
He won't be back until tomorrow.
Usvod, please. Thank you.
I don't think he's there, John.
Is he not?
No.
No. Probably gone to bed.
Oh.
Well, it is nearly 3 o'clock.
Hello, yes. I rang a second ago to speak to Usvod.
Yes, Mr. Shuttleworth.
Is he gone to bed?
Pardon?
Has he gone to bed already?
Don't be stupid.
I don't know.
Because it's...
I can connect you with the department.
Yes, if you would, please. Thank you.
No, nice one, Ken.
Yes. Oh, thank you.
I sense that this is the one.
Hello, yes. My name's Ken Worthington. I'm an impresario from England. And I manage a songwriter.
Called John Shuttleworth.
Called John Shuttleworth, who has a song called Pigeons in Flight, which we'd like to offer to you. For the Norwegian entry for the Eurovision Song Contest.
Okay, we already picked one.
You haven't, have you?
What?
Hmm?
What's she saying?
Oh, yes, we have. We have a song for the European Song Contest already.
Hello.
Hello.
Sorry, yes. This is John Shuttleworth here.
Yes.
I've actually been trying for several days to get through to you.
Okay.
Now, what is this that you were saying to him? You've picked the entry.
We already picked one. We picked one
but it's rubbish.
Saturday.
Gonna get nil pois. So I've just missed the boat.
Yes, you sure did.
Think it's a good song? Do you think it'll...
I haven't heard it.
So yes, because, I mean, you know, if you get nil point again, it would be a tragedy, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
I mean...
Yeah, but it's okay. Well, thank you for your offer anyway.
What about next year? Can I get in an early entry for next year?
Oh, don't
you can,
bother.
I'm not the person to talk to, actually.
It's Oswald, that. Isn't it?
Hmm?
Oswald.
Yes. Yes.
But he's not in.
He's not in.
He's gone to bed.
He's out of town.
Yeah.
Just a bit
sleepy. Well, I wish you every success with it.
Oh, thank you.
Come on, John.
Are you a singer? No.
Me?
Come
no.
on.
I'm just a secretary.
Yeah. Sure, Ken.
Okay, well...
You sound like a vocalist.
Mm-hmm.
Oh. Well, listen, thank you very much.
Yes, she does, doesn't she?
Thank you. And,
yeah, you're welcome.
And all the best.
Okay. Bye-bye.
Ciao, love. Bye. Oh. Sounded quite tasty, didn't she, that lady? Sorry.
Please, shut up, Ken. Please.
Hey, why don't you write a song for her for next year? Hey? Pigeons in
flight. The winning song is a song from Norway.
Hello, little girl.
Hello. I love that in Norway.
Pigeons in flight. I want to see you tonight.
See you tonight.
Oh, yes. I want to hold you.
If I may be so bold, too.
I'll tell you some things that you would like.
Would I like them?
To hear.
Oh, I hope so.
Oh, my dear.
Oh, my dear.
In your ear, oh, pigeons in flight. I want to see you tonight.
Norway goose flight.
I want to see you tonight.
Pigeon was written and performed by Graham Fellows and produced by Paul Schlesinger.
See you tonight. Oh, my pigeons in flight.
Come on, it wasn't that bad a decision. What's all the slow hand clapping?